students, in this lesson I'm going to teach you how to play a high third finger after a fourth finger. So a semitone between the third and the fourth. And I will give some tips for beginners, but I'll also give some tips using an example from the Brahms concerto, how to do this in very high position. So this lesson is really for all levels. For beginners, but also more advanced students, it's really important to make sure that you have a same hand position for all fingers. What I often see is that students have a different hand position per finger. So they're really, you know, your hand is always making the life of your fingers easier, of course. But if it's totally not stable and you have to do all kinds of weird things to place your fingers, that's not really good. And some people also have trouble playing vibrato, for example, because they need to do a special position for vibrato. So what you need to do is that if you place your fingers, they must be round. Your hand really embraces the neck of the violin. And you don't have to play like this, by the way, because you still have to look at your fingernails. But if you place the neck of your violin, some people have trouble, they place everything like this. I will show it from the other side. You see that everything is kind of straight, and then you need to try to change your posture in a way that you put your elbow a little bit there and a little bit up. Not too much, of course, don't strain yourself or anything, but some people play a little bit too much like that, and that's really hard to reach the notes and certainly to make good transitions between the notes, okay? And this moves while playing, you know, it moves per string, it moves per position you play in, so this is all flexible, there's not one rigid hold or something. Now then, if you put all fingers on the string and you find a good position, then you see that I slide my fourth finger over that third finger. When you play the fourth finger, the third finger should already be there. And if you're playing with vibrato, you can leave the first and maybe the second finger a little bit in the air. And but they must have sort of the same shape, so to say, because if you have a very flat pinky, for example, and then you try to, you see, it's almost impossible to place that third finger then. So it's more a general left hand technique thing. So from this side, yeah, really make your fingers a little bit round. They don't have to be completely like this, like this, and not a pinky like this, and then you see then it's not possible to place it in the right spot. So this is mainly for the first position for beginners, and also for like the third, fourth position. Now then I want to take an example from the Brahms Concerto bar 351, and this can be applied to, you know, semitones with a third and fourth finger in, yeah, like everywhere where you have that in high positions. And now slow motion close up to show you what I'm doing. So I just wanted to show you how close together they are. And then you really have to maintain your reference point on the violin, whether it's with your thumb here or here. And in contrary of what you do in lower positions, you might have to shift your fingers around a little bit because your finger might be thicker than the actual semitone. So maybe you need to, you know, make a little place for that fourth finger and then do something like this. It depends on the size of your fingers. And another solution that I do a bit further in bar 358 is to choose for fingering 3-3 instead of 4-3. So do this, you know, depending on the musical context, depending on your hand, it's very personal. So there I go from that E to a D. And then with the third finger, the D. Third finger also, so I go down a bit to the C sharp. And then I place the fourth finger again. So I do 3-3-4 actually. So after that I do play the D with the fourth finger. Well, I hope this was useful. Thanks so much for watching. And to get more lessons by me, just subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you next time. Bye bye.